Hi Aquarius, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and let's do a love read for you. Let's see how you're doing Aquarius now, how your person is doing and what action we can expect towards each other now. And these are general collective readings Aquarius, will not resonate with all of you. Take what works for you, leave the rest. So let's begin. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Aquarius and send them the messages they need to hear the most right now. Thank you. So Aquarius, let's begin your reading. Welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being supportive of the channel. And of course, if you're new here, Aquarius, we welcome you too. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. So Aquarius newbies, I'm going to explain this. I'm setting down two sets of cards here. One side is for you, one side is for your person. And then I'll have your mutual energies, action cards, dialogue messages, etc. But for the duration of the reading, I will be calling this side person A, this side person B. If this is your reading, you'll know exactly which side you resonate best with, right? So here we go. And if any of you are looking for a private reading, Aquarius, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. So bottom of my spread, I have the Five of Cups in reverse. Isn't that nice? Somebody is wanting to come out of regret or having any kind of sorrow or feeling bad about if something's happened between the two of you. This could be you, could be your partner, could be both of you. So let me just read out the cards to you. I have the Two of Swords and the Death card for person A. Seven of Wands, Four of Cups, Eight of Wands, Four of Wands. And for person B, they have the Ace of Cups, Temperance, High Priestess, Queen of Cups, Eight of Pentacles, and the Empress. Wow, beautiful cards. I mean, look at this. The last card for person A is the 11-11, Four of Wands, and the last card for person B is the Empress card, right? So from what I see here, Aquarius, quick glance, if somebody was not making a decision, or maybe now they don't want to make a decision, maybe at one point they were torn between two options, but they realized, hey, I don't want this to end, I can't let go, I don't want things to change between the two of us. And person B is also having this overflowing cup of love and trying to bring back balance into this relationship now. Okay, so yes, this could be the end of some troubles here. Before I start clarifying these cards, Aquarius, I'm going to take some dialogue message cards, see if you guys could say something to each other, what that would be. So Aquarius and that person spirit, if they could say something to each other now. Aquarius and their person, if they could say something to each other now, what would that be? Alright, let's take some true confessions as well. Aquarius and their person. Aquarius and their person. Oops, that's too many, but now that jumped out, I might as well take them. Alright, so Aquarius, the first card I have here for you. At first, I thought it was only a sexual attraction, but it's so much more than that. I love you, mind, body, and soul. So somebody's awakening to this love, and if there was, if somebody was not making that choice, they've realized, no, there is love here. Telling you that I need you will be the hardest thing I'll ever have to do. Because maybe in the past they didn't see the connection, now they recognize it, the awakening is happening between both of you. When you left me, I felt like it was because you did not think I was good enough. I know that I'm marriage material, and I know deep down you know that too. And yes, I do see both of you deep down know that this is a special connection. This lifetime didn't work out. Hopefully I can do better next time. So somebody is still a little scared here, especially person A is a bit scared here. They don't want this change. They don't want this change. Maybe they're still trying to hold off making that decision because they have fear. They have fear that, you know, I won't be accepted, and they're feeling, oh my God, I don't know. It'll be very hard for me now to say that, you know, you are the one and I love you. So maybe I can, or maybe I can never tell them that. So maybe this lifetime will be a total waste, and I'll have to wait for next lifetime to be together now. I feel so stupid for choosing lust over love. Missing you so much, we truly did have something special. It's hard because we can't seem to work out our differences. I'm happy for you. Okay, so let's clarify these cards, Aquarius, and see where we're going with this. I do see person A having a bit of trouble, right? They were unable to make a decision. They didn't want things, the dynamic to change maybe, or they had trouble accepting change. Maybe they, because it was because they kind of were a bit little defensive and not offering or accepting a love offer. But on person B side, I do see them feeling that love, wanting that commitment, and feeling an overflow of love for person A. So before I start clarifying these cards, Aquarius, I'm going to take an angel blessing card to see how my angels can bless this reading with a blessing, guidance, advice, or a message. Blessing, guidance, advice, or a message for Aquarius. Blessing, commitment. All right. So yes, Aquarius, that's exactly what I was saying here. This commitment was an issue maybe, or maybe now somebody does want to commit. The whole problem here has been regarding a marriage or a commitment. Okay, so let's put this card here. Let's start clarifying these cards and see where we go from here. So let's start with the energies of person A, Aquarius. I don't know whether this side is you or the other side is you. For me, this is person A, right? So person A has the Two of Swords. Why are they feeling in the Two of Swords energy, Spirit? Why are they feeling in the Two of Swords energy? My God, two of... This person is very confused. Two of Swords, clarified by the Two of Swords, with the Lovers card, which is again a card of having to make a choice, having to make a choice, and not knowing whether they want to, whether they have it in them to put in that investment or not. This person has a huge problem making any kind of change, or, you know, make a decision, because they don't like change in their life. Death in reverse. Why is the death card in reverse for them? Yeah, see, this person A likes the exciting part of this connection. Where it's passionate, where it's exciting, they're all for it. This is a Ace of Wands. I mean, like, you know, let's have fun. But the minute it comes down to commitment, this person freezes up. Oh my God, I'll have to do something now. I'll have to commit. I'll have to offer something. I don't want to make that decision. I don't want change. I like things the way they are, when we can just have fun and I never have to take responsibility for anything in my life. So this person is still in there. They could be older, but they still behave like a child, where they don't want to take responsibility to actually change things around in this dynamic. So what happened in the recent past, Spirit? Seven of Wands. What's the Seven of Wands? Yes, this person, Seven of Wands, clarified by the Seven of Wands. What a reading. So yes, this person has always been a bit immature maybe, or then maybe very rash in their ways, never taking responsibility. Knight of Wands is, again, I would say a teenager, right? Who kind of just is very rash and never takes responsibility for their actions, always kind of warding off, any kind of structure in their life. Four of Cups, Spirit? What's this, Four of Cups? I think their partner finally felt quite defeated, felt quite neglected, felt as if, they were not being offered what they deserved. And they felt they were dealing with somebody who was manipulating them. This is a trickster who, just creates illusions and doesn't step up to the plate. Never really invests in anything proper. They just say or do things to cover things up, what a magician does, and especially when the magician is in reverse, not the nicest kind, I would say, quite a trickster. And I think person B was looking for an emperor here who would take back, take control of this relationship, who would be the, person who would be in charge of, their life and take it forward. So because I think their partner always felt neglected and always feeling abandoned and sad and lonely and never, receiving that proper offer of commitment. I think somebody decided, hey, I'm not going to be in this kind of place anymore. I might as well move on. So I have a feeling person A's person, who's person B, moved on. So now how do they feel about person A, B, Spirit? How does person A feel about this connection now with person B? Eight of Wands. Why do they feel the Eight of Wands? They want a transformation now. This person A now wants communication back. They want to talk. They want to kind of get this relationship back up and running. They want some kind of a transformation. They definitely don't want it to end. One more Spirit for the Eight of Wands. Yes, they want one more chance. They've realized who their person is. They want one more chance. Till now, they didn't want to make any changes because they wanted to behave like a teenager, but they didn't want to be, that person who's in control and can actually get things done or create stability for their partner. But now I think this is how they feel. They want to have now back and forth communication with person B. They want to transform this dynamic. They do want to try one more time because they see the potential in this connection. Yes. But there is some kind of fear. I think they're a little scared of person B. They don't have the courage maybe to face them. Why is that, Spirit? Why is the Four of Wands here with the Devil card? Oh, they're scared to tell them. This is what they want. They want this communication. They want to transform this connection. They want to fight for it one more time. They have seen the potential of this Four of Wands connection. But this person is kind of a little bit of a coward, if I may say so. They don't have the courage right now. They're a little scared. Oh my God, what will I say? I want this communication. But they're going back and forth in their mind. How do I say it? What do I say? Because they know they've kind of messed up in the past, right? Let's see what's happening with person B now. Person B has the Ace of Cups and the Temperance card. Why is the Ace of Cups here, Spirit, for person B? Ace of Cups. Yes, person B has a lot of love for person A, or at least had. And but something happened which made them walk away from it. Why, Spirit? Why did person B, in spite of having all that love, walk away from their partner? Why did they have to walk away? Maybe because there was no emotions expressed from person A's side. They felt emotionally quite drained. They felt, all the cups were empty. What I got from person A, I might as well go look for, my Two of Cups now. Yes, they went silent. I think they started to tap into their own spirituality or started listening to their own intuition. Maybe stopped talking to person A and went off to heal themselves in solitude. Yes, this This was probably a tower moment. I think this tower moment was for person A. When person B walked away, this was a tower moment, for person A to say, hey, you know, I'm going quiet on you. I'm going to go turn my back and see what else is out there. And just kind of, blew up that tower one fine day and walked away. Or is planning to, I don't know. Temperance. What's this temperance card? Yes, person B got tired. Person B was exhausted of carrying all the burden by themselves. They feel, 10 wands? How about you take 5 of them? My back is bent, I'm tired, I can't see anything in front of me. If I'm going to carry all the wands on my own, I don't want to. I'm going to, kind of blow this relationship up. I'm going to just take a few with me, which I need, and I'm going to go off and see what else is out there. Maybe I'll find somebody else who can, share the load with me. And person B has kind of gone into a mode where they are trying to heal themselves. So what happened in the recent past, Spirit, for them to feel this way? They wanted commitment. They wanted commitment, and they were very loving, kind, and they wanted that back. They wanted a partnership with person B. So let's clarify the Hierophant, Spirit. What's this Hierophant? Yes, they wanted a brand new beginning. Let's start together. And if that can't happen, then fine. I'm going to shut this chapter down completely. They started to feel that because I think person A was not offering commitment, they started understanding that person A, they started finding person A a little selfish and a bit self-centered. And that's the reason I think person B decided, I'm going to go in for self-love now. I do have a lot of love for person A, but I think it's time I took back my love for myself, completed this chapter of my life, closed this out, and maybe move on for the next whatever has to come in my life. Person B went into self-love here. Okay, so how does person B now feel about person A, Spirit? Eight of Pentacles in reverse. They feel person A never really put in the work. Clarify Eight of Pentacles, Spirit. How does person B feel about person A now? How does person B feel about person A? Yes, I think person B has also figured out that, hey, I am going to go and be happy on my own. I think they've been waiting around for a long time. They were waiting that one day, my person A is going to bring me that happiness, is going to do the right thing. But all they got was always feeling left out in the cold and abandoned by person A. And that's the reason I think they feel this relationship or this person is now not worth putting in any more effort or any more work. Person B has now kind of ascended, from being the Queen of Cups, from being that over-loving, kind, always being generous to person A, to turning their back and saying, hey, I gave myself self-love and look at me now, I'm the Empress. I don't chase anymore. I attract. So, what's this Empress card, Spirit? Empress. Yes, I think they waited a long time for person A to make them feel like the Empress first. They really waited, they were codependent, let's say, on person A to make them feel good, maybe offer them commitment, make them their spouse or wife, husband, whatever. And when this did not happen, nothing really moved, there was no forward movement from person A's side. This Queen of Cups started feeling very drained. They felt, I keep pouring, and look at me now, I've become totally drained out. How long will I wait for this person to come towards me and nurture me as the Empress? So I think now, because there was no justice given to this person B, they've taken back their power and they have now turned away, to say, I'll do it on my own. I'm no longer wanting to put in any more work, any more investment into somebody who's never going to do the right thing. Now we have to pull two different people. Person A has now figured out they want to have this conversation, they want to have this forum once, but they are scared now of this communication, and person B has taken back their power now. Okay, so let's see what, if possible, what action will person A take now. Two of pentacles in reverse. Why is that an action that person A will take now, spirit? Why is that an action? What are they dropping? They feel they've been dropped already. They feel they've been dropped already. They do want to work with person B desperately because person B makes them happy. But right now, the problem here is they feel even if they go with any kind of offer, it's going to be rejected outright. Why? Because they've made some foolish mistakes in the past. They did not take that leap of faith. And so here this person is. Now, this is the action they're going to be taking, Aquarius. No action. I think they're just going to be healing for a while and praying and asking God to help, I think. Because this person is thinking about all that they've done. As much as they want to, they know what makes them happy. They feel that I've already been dropped. What can I do now? I know who makes me happy. I know who I want to be with. But I feel foolish now. So here they are, by themselves, praying, thinking, planning. Let's see what person B will do now. What action? Knight of Cups. Oh my God, is this Empress going towards new love spirit? I think so. Knight of Cups and the Page of Wands. I think this Empress is now open. This Empress is open to either somebody coming back from their past or new love. They are in that flow of energy where they're saying, I just want to be happy. I just want to be happy. If somebody has to come towards me, they better come in correct. They better come in with emotion and yes, prove that they can be my friend first. I don't think person B is stuck on the past, but they are open to love now, finally. Am I right, spirit? Any action from person B? Yes, they're coming out of the zone where they were always feeling neglected and tired and never feeling good enough, right? Always feeling that nobody loves me. So I think the person B has really, really kind of empressed up, if that's a word. And yes, they are happy to meet new people, have new friends, accept new love if there is, or old love if there is, but it has to come in correct, it has to be emotional, it has to be in a natural flow of energy. So this Empress is opening up now. So person A, if you really want your Empress, don't think too much. This Empress will be snapped up very, very quickly. Okay? Yeah, somebody needs to pick up their sword and go and have that communication, that direct communication, which I know a person is trying to, but they don't know what to say, how to say it. They do want to try one more time. I want to talk to them. I want to give it one more shot, but feeling so foolish. All right, so that's all I have for you, Aquarius. Till next time then, love and light. Take care. Namaste.